Hi guys, it's Kylie the Jellyfish. Today, I'm gonna have another video about extensions for you. I haven't filmed a video in a while. I've been really focused on my new job and school and everything, but as you can see, I have silver hair right now. I also got a haircut, so it's shorter in the back, a little longer in the front, and I love it. So recently, VP Fashion released a new shade in their hair extensions. All of the hair extensions that you know I've got were the 613A, which is or was their lightest shade, and now they have a new color that is a light blonde, but it's supposed to be a little bit lighter than the previous lightest shade. So they sent me a pair of the hair extensions. It's called Sandstone, and in my mind I would think Sandstone should be like a darker blonde color, but it's supposed to be paler, and this color is meant for if you want to have very pastel colors. And the perfect thing for me right now is that my hair is silver. It's really hard to find hair extensions that are light enough to dye silver. So hopefully these will work out, and I'm going to experiment with them today to show you exactly how light they are. The extensions will come in this pretty box. It's sturdy. So I actually have a sample of the old hair extensions that I always received. I have all the pairs hanging on my wall over there. It's kind of weird when someone walks in, they're like, why do you have hair hanging on your wall? They were all made with this color right here. This is the white blonde. Now, the extensions that are new are the Sandstone, which is this color right here. I think it's 60. Yeah, the hair color is 60. Versus 613. To me, honestly, I open these in my hair salon that I work at now, and seeing them in the lighting and in the mirror holding it up, to me it feels like this pair is just darker. Even though it's supposed to be lighter, I will say it is paler. Like, it's much more mute and much more of a cooler tone. This one is obviously a very golden blonde. I do think that it could work with my hair. As you can see, my hair is not a very bright silver. It's a darker silver. It's like it's a neutrally medium silver. And these extensions, the blonde golden ones, just wouldn't work out with it because they're just simply too yellow. But even though I was surprised that these, in my opinion, are not as light as I thought they would be, I thought they would be much brighter, but they are cool enough that I think they could pass as silver if I tone them correctly. The white blonde ones, the old ones, are, I feel like, a little bit shinier upon being golder, but these ones just have more of a matte look to them. They don't have much shine. Maybe it's how they toned them or how they lifted them to this color. I'm not sure the whole process of how they do that. I'm curious to see how these are really going to look when I apply the toners and the dyes on them that I need in order to turn them this color. Alright, so next up I will just show you guys how I tone them and all the process that I go through in order to turn these to match my hair. Also, the links for these hair extensions will be in the description below, as well as the information. Instead of using direct dyes like Manic Panic or Arctic Fox, today I decided to use toners, which you have to mix with the developer. So I got the developer from Sally Beauty Supply. It's just 10 volume because usually you don't want to go on a high volume for toner. I used 3 different toners by Ion, which you can buy at Sally Beauty Supply, and one by Pulp Riot. The Pulp Riot one was the one that I currently have my hair toned to. I really recommend the Pulp Riot Silver Toner, but unfortunately it's available for professional use only, but the other toners from Ion are available for public use. I used a little bit of Icy White, which has somewhat of a blue tint to it. Usually bluer toners can fade out to a green color, and I used a little bit of the Spring Blossom, which is a pinker tone, to cancel out those green tones in the blue. And then Snowcap is a really true silver, so I definitely recommend that one if you want to have a very true silver pigment. The usual ratio for mixing developer and toner is 1 part toner to 2 parts developer. I then whisked it all together to the correct consistency. If it's too watery, then you probably put too much developer in it, and if it's too stiff, it's probably too much toner.
The toner works really fast, so I was working really sloppy and really fast. I just grabbed it with my hands, which means I probably should have been wearing gloves, but I didn't. I washed my hands right after that, though. I just grabbed the toner in my hands, and I just smushed it into the extensions. I made sure to flip it around and really squish it in there, just to make sure I didn't have any missing spots. If I had a lower developer, it would have worked much slower, but I only had 10 volumes, so I just had to work with what I had. I could already see the first one that I put the toner on to start turning really, really dark, so I started to work faster and faster because I didn't want it to be too dark on one pair of the hair extensions and super light on the last few pairs. But as soon as I finished up putting all the toner on the hair, I mushed it in really well and just massaged it from the top to the ends and the mid shaft and everywhere that I thought I might have missed any spots. I ran it over to my shower and I rinsed them out one by one, starting with the first pair that I did. So the darkest pair that had been developing for the longest, that's the one I rinsed out first. But there was one part that I just didn't film because I didn't feel like it. I rinsed out the toner and all of the toner was a little bit too dark. It was just a few shades darker than my hair color now, and I didn't feel like having to retone my hair. So what I did was I took clarifying shampoo that just strips out hair dye, and I shampooed up the hair extensions really well, rinsed it out, and then it was a light enough color that matched my hair perfectly. Then I dried them with my hair dryer really quick, and I let the rest air dry a little bit. But then the next day, I styled them to match my hair. So I used a waver tool that I got from Ulta Beauty, and it's by Bedhead. It's kind of like this waver tool that just makes your hair wavy instead of curly, and I just find it's a really fun way to wear my hair.
Alrighty, thank you guys so much for watching. Please leave this video a like if you liked it, and subscribe to me if you haven't. Also, definitely check out VP Fashion. If you're watching this around the time of in between the 16th and the 31st of October of 2017, make sure you get your hair extensions now if you're ever gonna get them, because the discount code JELLYFISH is off for way more than if you were to buy them any other time. So take advantage of this opportunity and get your extensions now. Thanks so much. Stay epic.